still using these boring slides, level up your presentation with these sleek and modern infographic designs. These designs will make your slide more dynamic, engaging, and professional. Hello everyone, welcome to another PowerPoint tutorial. In this video, I'll show you how to create these professional infographics step by step. Plus, I've got a bonus for you, so make sure to watch till the end. Now let's get started. Just a quick note, we have already covered these two slides in the previous video. You can check it out by clicking the I button at the top. Now let's continue. Go to Insert tab, Shapes, Insert and Block Arc, slightly adjust its width and the size. Now extend one of the edges to give it a rounded look, duplicate it to create another one. Next, rotate it so we can join the edges of both the shapes. Slightly adjust the edges of the upper one. Now reposition this to join it with the first one. Slightly adjust the corners to give it a seamless look. I'm still not satisfied. Keep adjusting the edges and the corners until you are satisfied with the final look. That's perfect. Duplicate the shape again and place it at the right. Now rotate it to join the edges with the previous one. Repeat the process one more time. Duplicate the shape and rotate it to join the edges. Perfect. Next, select all and remove the outlines. Now slightly adjust the position using the arrow key to create a seamless look. Next, insert a rectangle and remove its outline. Now duplicate this arc shape to create one more. Keep adjusting it to create a smooth path connecting the rectangle with the existing circular path. That looks perfect. Extend the rectangle to the left edge of the slide. Now duplicate this rectangle and place it at the bottom right. Duplicate this arc shape as well. Go to Shape Format, Rotate, then flip it vertically and then horizontally. Adjust its position and then join the rectangle to the edge of the arc. Further, extend the rectangle to the right edge of the slide. Now, we can create two types of infographics with this design. Let's do them one by one. Bring the icon to the middle of the circular section. You may customize it as per your need. Now let's add text to the slides. Now let's add color to the design. Select these topmost elements and choose a blue color. For the remaining shapes, use black. Next, let's add animation effects. Select the rectangle, go to Animation tab, apply the wipe effect and change the effect option to the left. Now use the animation painter tool to replicate the effect for the remaining circular and rectangle pieces. Make sure to change the wipe effect options for each shape accordingly. Next, open the animation pane, select all effects except the first one and choose Start After Previous. Now select this text box and apply Fly In effect and change the effect option to left. Double click on the effect to open the settings, adjust the smooth start and bounce end. Place this animation effect at the very beginning of the timeline. For the second effect, choose Start After Previous. Now select the first icon and apply the zoom effect. For the heading, choose the fade effect and for the text, choose the zoom effect. Now adjust the animation timings in the animation pane. Select the third and fourth effect and choose Start After Previous. Now replicate the animation effect using the animation painter tool for the remaining icon and text boxes. Finally, select this smaller arc shape and set their duration 2.2 seconds. And we are done. Let's preview the slide. Moving on, let's create another infographic using the same design. Duplicate the slide and bring the gear icon from the first slide. You can use the Icons tab in PowerPoint to find a gear icon or you can create one yourself. Click the I button at the top to learn how to create a gear icon in PowerPoint. Let's continue. Delete all the icon headings. Now adjust the position and size of the gear icon. Next, select all the other icons and slightly decrease their size. Now select these three, navigate to Shape Format, Align, make it center and middle align. Now copy the gear icon, place it below. Select these three shapes and make it center and middle align. Repeat the process for remaining two sections. Now let's animate the slide. Since all the elements including the gears already have animation effects applied, we just need to adjust the timings in the animation pane. There are two effects applied to each gear icon, zoom and spin. Select the effect of first gear and place it before the second effect in the timeline. Select the icon's zoom effect and place it after the second effect and choose start after previous. For the spin effect, choose start with previous. For the text group animation, choose start on click. Now apply these same timing setting to the second, third and fourth section of the infographics. For the second and fourth gear, change the spin setting to counterclockwise for a more realistic look. Let me change the color of the first and third gear to black. And we are done. Let's preview the slide. That's it for this video. If you want this template along with some additional infographics, simply like this video, subscribe to the channel and drop a comment below with your email ID. And I'll send it straight to your inbox. So if you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe and hit the bell icon for more such amazing content. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.